Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. Apparently the software update is complete, even though I only just clicked on this. Preparing. Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. So, for those of you who don't know, or couldn't tell from the title, today, April 15th, is the day that Mewtwo is being released to people who registered both Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS on Club Nintendo before March 31st. And basically, we're getting him, like, early. So, your friends can send replays, Mii Fighters, snapshots, and stages to you using share mode. You can also receive notifications. Yes, please. So, this is not only just a Mewtwo update. It's also, it's like a balance patch, and it adds the sharing features. And also, it is still taking a long time to load. Don't worry, the footage hasn't stopped. It's just still loading. And it also comes with a whole bunch of Mii Fighter outfits. I believe you can get all of them on both versions for about $10. So, I think I'm going to do that. And also, there we go. Version 1.0.6. Now, I need... Oh, here we go. We can jump into the Nintendo eShop from the notification screen. View the notification screen by selecting notices in eShop. Interesting. So they've changed that so it's not just notices anymore. Okay, we can go to the eShop. You can buy downloadable content for Super Smash Bros. In the Nintendo eShop. If you already have the download code, you can enter that here too. You can choose between content for Wii U only and content for both Wii U and 3DS. If you select Wii U, you can only use that content on this console. And blah blah blah. You can find the Nintendo 3DS download code in the account activity. I don't need that because you already have the codes from Club Nintendo. And it's the same on the 3DS version. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, of course, I'm going to download Mewtwo onto my Wii U here. I can't record from the 3DS just yet, so I won't be doing a video on that, but it is pretty much just going to be exactly the same process. But I'm assuming if I buy the, here it is. Mii Fighter Costume Bundle for Wii U and 3DS right here. So that's the one I'm going to get. So I'm going to go ahead and purchase that. Of course, I'm not going to show you guys my credit card details, so I'll be cutting the video for when I input those. Whenever that's going to be. Next. I own it. I do own it. I was just in the game. That's how I got here. Alright. I'm gonna just input my credit card details real quick. Okay. That should do it. It actually had them saved. I didn't realize that I had them saved to the console, so that actually took a lot less time than I thought it was gonna do. So, if any of you guys don't want to see all of this crap and you just want to see Mewtwo gameplay, I will have left a thing on the screen telling you what time frame to go to. Okay, sorry for the cut. I didn't want to, like, show you guys the code there. So, yeah. Okay. So now that I've added the funds, I can go ahead and download this. View checked items. Next. I'm just doing that. This video might be kind of long. Some of this content is already on the console. Yeah, okay. I didn't think it had already downloaded it. I just wanted... Because you guys do not even know how excited I am for Mewtwo. But I am. I'm very excited. Alright, download will start automatically. And now, what we need to do is we need to redeem the Mewtwo code. So we're going to go to the eShop home. I'm going to load up my emails. I believe you just go to enter download code. And I'm going to go ahead and enter my code here. Okay, there he is. I was getting confused. It didn't work straight away, and I'd entered one of the digits wrong. I put a 4 instead of a J for some reason. I own it. Please download my Mewtwo faster. I'm surprised it already did the software update, because there was people installing it, like, last night, and it was taking forever. So maybe it did it... My Wii U was in standby overnight, so maybe it just did it. That's pretty cool. And with that, I think if we go to our download management, give it a second, download management, Rider of Lightning is online, download stuff complete, so if we could go ahead and go back, I want to load up with my GameCube controller, not my gamepad, So I'll grab that. And, well, actually, we might have to restart the game. Now that I think about it. Yeah, he's not there yet, so we're gonna go ahead and go back and restart this. If it does look a slight bit worse than you're used to, I have actually downscaled the Wii U to 720p just so that my Elgato can record it in 60 frames per second, because I don't have an Elgato HD 60 and I wanted this to be in 60 FPS, so... Just because it's Mewtwo. I wanted my friggin' Mewtwo to be in friggin' 60 FPS. Okay, so now it's gonna install the downloadable content. So... Yeah. And we are done, I think. Preparing twice, like it did earlier. Okay, here we go! Oh my god, Mewtwo is friggin' Mewtwo! I'm so excited! What's betting it's gonna take forever to load up the game again? Oh, that took an unhealthy amount of time to load. I was like sat in suspense on a black screen. Oh, that's awesome. Mewtwo Alt Trophy? Sweet. Proto Man's Helmet, X's Helmet, Cat Hat, Link Cap, Dunban Wig, Majora's Mask, Monkey Hat, Super Smash Bros. T-Shirt, Proto Man's Armor, X's Armor, Cat Suit, Link Outfit, Dunban Outfit, Monkey Suit. Ah! All that for $10. Not even $10. And Mewtwo. Alright. Okay, we're just gonna go straight into a Smash match. Oh, there he is! Just hearing the Zandamobus, just hearing Zandamobus say that is awesome. Also, interestingly, they've moved Villager up here, which is odd. I guess they're gonna just shift these two over and put Lucas right here whenever he shows up. So, anyway, let's go ahead. I'm only gonna put this as a CPU level 3 just because I don't exactly want to die on my first fight with Mewtwo. Look at that! That, I swear, that's a reference to Shadow Lugia. Alright, and of course, Pokemon Stadium 2, Omega Form. Let's freaking go. Now, as far as I know, he does have his melee moveset. So, hopefully I'm not too bad as him. Because I did use him a lot in melee. Also, that dunk looks sick! Oh my god, I knew he had a freaking Meteor Smash, but that looks awesome. Okay, I dunked him upwards. Oh, they don't have the little whoop for the teleport, but that's fine. And I don't have items on, but I believe that whenever he picks up an item, it still appears, it just like floats in front of him. Okay, you just hit me. Let's hit him with a forward throw. Yeah! And a shadow ball. Oh, he doesn't go Naeem anymore. And disable. Oh, that looks amazing. Oh, look, he's freaking drunk. Ugh. Oh, we're gonna get a dunk. Oosh! Oh, he still has his melee taunt. Oh, that looked amazing. Oh, that's so cool. This is his exact melee moveset. But, oh, it's so good to play as him in Smash 4, though, because if you guys watch my melee videos, I'm not very good at melee. What are his other taunts? Okay, so that was in the trailer, and that was, like, at the very end of the trailer. That's awesome. But this is exactly his melee moveset, and now, because I'm better at Smash 4 than I am at melee, it just feels so much more natural. Oh, get the dunk! Oh, that's badass. Oh, and look at the CPU. He is not about to clap. This man is not about to clap when he loses. Oh my god. Okay, there's something else I want to do, just because I'm assuming it exists. I'm going to go ahead and do the Palutena's Guidance for Mewtwo. Because I'm assuming that's a thing. So we just need to go to... Where's Palutena's Temple? There it is. I normally just pick random Omega, so... Yeah, hopefully he doesn't hit me while I activate it. Okay, he's all the way over there. Okay, how do you do this? I believe you just tap down on the... Is that not right? Is that wrong? I don't know how you do it. Oh, there we go. Please no hit me. Please don't hit me. Please don't hit me. Screw you! Okay, can I still do it? Please, please. I really should have gone. No, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and I'll set him up as a CPU, as not a CPU, as a second player. I don't know why I didn't do that before. Look at him, he just stood there like he does not even care. He does not even care right now. Alright, let's load up my pro controller. And Mewtwo it up. And let's try this again. He was doing it, but Mewtwo was like, no, I'm gonna poke you and you can stop doing it real quick. Alright. Oh, this Mewtwo is in the building. Alright, let's go over here, actually. Let's bring him. No, don't taunt. Don't taunt. Let's bring him over. Alright, let's go. How do I do this? I think I just... I've been tapping it over and over again. There we go. I need to drink as well. Like, alright, let's go, Pit.
Who is that? I have no data on this fight.
Oh my god!
It must be an intruder.
It's the secret...
Whoever it is, the goal remains the same.
It's...
to fight and win!
That Palutena's guidance conversation was hidden in the data of the game way, way back. And people, like, found it in the oh my god. Okay. I figured that was gonna be from you two. I thought that- oh, okay. Look at him, he doesn't even care. Oh my god. Sorry, I'm, like, hyping way too much right now. So... in fact, we need to go ahead and take a look at that trophy that it gave us. Because I have all but one of the trophies. And one of them is just from getting a, oh my god. One of them is just from getting a, collecting all the, like, hats or something like that, or all of the custom moves. So Mewtwo's Confusion Side Special not only reflects projectiles, but also reflects the damage back on your opponent. Its down special disable stuns an enemy for longer, the higher its damage is. Disable only works on foes that are facing Mewtwo. So what I want to know is what does his Classic Mode trophy look like? Now, I'm not going to be showing the whole Classic Mode run here, but I am going to do it. I'm about to play through friggin' Classic Mode with Mewtwo. I'm going to do it on 7.5, because that's pretty much what I did every other one on. By the way, there's a Melee video coming out in the near future where I talk about how I haven't done the Classic on 9.0 without losing a stock. I did that yesterday. So, yeah, it was tough. But I'm going to take on this actual fight here with... I'm going to actually include this one because I've only really shown one real Mewtwo fight. He's so badass! Oh my god, I love him. I love him so much. Yeah, get down throwed. My voice is going all croaky. Oh my god. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just so excited. I'm so excited! Because I'm assuming that they've incorporated a new Classic trophy. A new Classic Mode trophy, since the Mewtwo trophy that's in the game already doesn't look like his official artwork. Also, does he have custom moves? I should check that. I don't know if he's got custom moves. I would imagine that he does. But... I guess if we unlock any in this Classic Mode run, then we'll know. Oh, this is so badass. Friggin' my baby Mewtwo's here! My baby Mewtwo's here! Alright, well... I'm just gonna go ahead and cut to whenever we get to the end, just so I can see what his trophy is like. Just wanted to confirm, he does indeed still hold items in front of him. And it's freaking badass. Look at this. Boom! He does not even care. Wait, do they still spin? They spin around him when he taunts. They spin around him when he taunts. Oosh! Oh my god, Smash Ball! Smash Ball! And also, I'm doing really badly against this freaking Metal Shulk. Smash Ball! Go! Mega Mewtwo Y! Mind Crush! Go! Boom! Okay. Moment of truth. Well, I guess it's in a little while. Like, once we actually beat Master Hand Master Crazy. Whoa! Oh, am I gonna die? Okay. I actually, like, the last time I fought these guys was as a customized Bowser. So, and that was on, like, 9.0. And I actually didn't find them too tough. Probably just because Bowser's, like, smash attacks are ridiculously powerful. Especially when he's, like, powered up. Plus no kill. There we go. Whew. It's actually taken me a while to get here, surprisingly. Also, I am going to do an All-Star Mode run. I'm not going to do it on hard, because I've actually already beaten it on hard with all the characters. And I'm wondering, if you hadn't beaten it on hard with all the characters before the Mewtwo DLC, would that challenge include Mewtwo? I'm not sure. That's probably something I'm going to go check. Like, if it's changed to all regular characters or something and not DLC. So I can't imagine that they'd make you do it with an extra character. Maybe they would. I don't know. There we go, Master Giant taken out. Get a taunt in there. I love Mewtwo. Mewtwo new main can confirm. I'm sorry, Mario, but you're not Mewtwo. Yeah! I love this so much. I love him so much. I love him so much. I love him so much. Mewtwo's back. Oh god, I'm legitimately tearing up a little bit. Mewtwo is here. Oh my god. I don't know why I'm still taunting, why am I not hitting? I love what they did with this forward air. Like, it's the same kind of forward air, but it just looks slightly different. I mean, look at that, it's like a shadow claw. Also, I always get hit by that attack, I'm terrible with it. Nope. Okay, I don't normally get hit by that, but alright. And I'm pretty sure on 7.5 you don't fight Master Fortress. So it's just going to be a case of, there we go, defeating Master Edges. And then defeating the clone Mewtwo, which is a clone of a clone, may I add. Honestly, I'm probably going to die here. Oh, this is so badass. Clone of a clone. Ugh! Oh, I thought that I was going to dunk him. Also, he's really not doing much to me. He's not doing anything to me. Okay, and for those of you wondering, I will also do a video on Lucas whenever he's released. It might not end up being as... Okay, he killed me. Might not end up being as long as the Mewtwo one, but still. Out you go. Is he not dead yet? Oh, he's right there. I couldn't see him. Boom! Shadow Ball. Okay, at least we don't have to do Master Fortress. That's kind of why I did it on 7.5 and not 8. Just keep hitting your down smashes. Hit it with an up smash. And a forward smash. Ugh. One more down smash. Last down smash. Boom! Awesome. I'm just gonna tweet out, Mewtwo, new main, can confirm. Sorry, Mario. Okay, there we go. And we didn't get any Mewtwo customs, but I don't know if there is any Mewtwo customs. This music's so relaxing. And there it is! So we do have a new Classic Mode trophy, and I'm going to assume we're also gonna have a new freaking All-Star trophy, Final Smash trophy. Yeah, you join the fight, Mewtwo. You join the fight. Now the final task is to try and complete the frigging ending puzzle. Because I usually struggle with this, if I'm honest. Although his frigging up tilt, I love it so much. Yeah, I usually struggle with these puzzles. There's certain characters I can get it no problem, like the bigger characters. But how am I gonna know if I can do it with Mewtwo? Because I've never played as Mewtwo in Classic Mode before today. Then again, neither has anybody. Although Japan actually had the codes yesterday, and I was looking up a couple videos. There was one guy who posted like one of his victory screens and stuff like that. Okay, so by the looks of things, you can't tilt his forward smash, which is fine. But yeah. Also, pretty much the only thing they've changed from his melee moveset is, of course, they've added in the ending to his jab. Which is perfectly fine, because that's what they do in the Smash 4s. Also, look at all the little Pikachu! Okay. Keep hitting these. I'm not doing too good here. I need to get rid of this screw attack. It's screwing me up. Haha. Because I have it, like, I'm jumping up to try and hit the text higher up, and it's destroying them before they get up there. So at least it's gone now. I love how if you jump and do the double jump and then immediately hit, like, a standard, a neutral air, he, like, floats up using the neutral air and it looks badass. Okay. Maybe we can do this. Maybe that was famous last words. Okay, so I can tilt the forward tilt, like, up a little bit. Okay, come on. It's just this. Is that it? That looks like the last thing. There we go! Did it! Okay, let's move this screw attack onto my body. And with that, that is so cool. Look at him holding up the little Pikachu. Yeah. Alright, well, I'm excited for his little ending video. Oh, he was sleeping with Pikachu. Okay, there is this classic trophy. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. Gallery. I'm assuming... No, I guess he doesn't have a trophy box. Okay. Mewtwo puts its psychic powers to great use in this game. Not only does it have floaty jumps, but its telekinesis gives its attacks extra reach and throws added power. However, its light body makes it easier to launch, so if you're willing to risk getting in close, it just might be worth it. So Mewtwo is one of the lighter fighters in this game, which is good. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and take on All-Star mode. I'm only going to do it on easy just to get through it. As you'll see here, I have beaten it on hard with all the characters, even Olimar, which was frigging tough, and as was Villager. And I will do it on hard with Mewtwo later. But for right now, I'm just going to do it on easy just so we can get the trophy. So, yeah. Let's do that, shall we? Ready, go! Oh my god, look how badass this back throw is! He doesn't even turn around to look, he's just like, no, get out of my face. Oh my god. I love this so much. Oh, I didn't even notice. Mewtwo's been added into this section of All-Star mode. I seriously didn't even notice. I don't know why I didn't figure that would happen. But he's here, and that's amazing. Oh my god. And he appears, actually, he was the last one to appear, which means he's the first one in the thing, implying that he's the first Pokemon out of the four from Kanto in this game. Because it always appears, like, it does Jigglypuff, Charizard, then Pikachu, because it's, like, going backwards in the Pokedex number, and then Mewtwo comes after them, so that's odd. He's in number 150. Also, get the frigging dunk! Boom! Done. That was not tough, because it was on easy mode. I'm kind of excited to take it on hard mode, though, just because I beat it on hard mode with literally everybody. And so far, oh my god, look at it, look at it. I love how it's got regular Mewtwo in there. Ah. Anyway, what was I going to say? Like, I feel like I did a lot better with Mewtwo, or I feel like Mewtwo already is one of my better characters. Which is odd because he only just came out, but like there's certain characters I just can't get used to the playstyle for. And they were definitely the ones that I had more trouble with. So also, what is this image? Is this supposed to be the Wii Fit trainers trying to get Mewtwo to take his medicine? Is that really what this is? Or is this a reference to Pokemon First Movie? And that's supposed to be like Dr. Fuji or something. I don't know, but either way, Mewtwo is freaking here, and I'm gonna check if he does have any custom moves before we end off the video. I'll just go to the customize menu. If it has the option to select custom moves, then I imagine he does have custom moves, so... Well, I'm kind of hoping he does, just because I've actually only got 3 custom moves left to unlock. That's 1 for Ike and 2 for Bowser Jr. If my throat would stop clogging up, jeez. It'd just give me a couple more to unlock. Which, honestly, I don't like unlocking custom moves because they take forever and it's incredibly tedious to unlock them. But I could do that from YouTube, especially if it was just the one character that I need to unlock them for. Alright, almost done. Done! Let's just skip all this. Look at that image. And I like how he still has the laugh as well. He's like... So cool! Alright, all-star mode done. Alright, we just got the same ending video again. I don't know why I thought it'd be different, because I'm fairly certain for every character it's the same no matter which mode you're playing, but... let's go ahead and take a look at that trophy. Psystrike. Mewtwo's final smash starts as Mewtwo Mega Evolves into Mega Mewtwo Y. It then fires a huge psychic projectile that penetrates enemies and obstacles. This projectile doesn't do any damage, but it freezes every foe it hits in place. They can even be frozen mid-jump. Afterward, every foe will be hit with the projectile. Hit with the projectile will take a powerful psychic hit to the head. So, it's a mind crush. Alright, so we got all three of those Mewtwo trophies now. There's actually another two. There's like two that were already in the game. So let's go ahead and head to the custom menu, not Mii Fighters. Although I do want to show off the new outfits that we got. Because I bought them. Let's go to Mewtwo. Mewtwo! Let's see. Special. So, I'm guessing he does have custom... There are no custom specials? Oh, does that mean I haven't unlocked them, or they don't exist? But I'm just gonna go to Bowser Jr., because if the ones on I don't have on Bowser Jr. are the same special move, I can check if it says the same thing. Let's see. Okay, no. I just need that one of those and one of those. So... I don't know, does that mean he doesn't have any custom moves? Because it doesn't really specify, it just says there are none. Does that mean I haven't unlocked them? Which I haven't. Or does it mean that they don't exist? That's odd. Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and customize my Mii. Let's give him some headgear. Order obtained, I'm guessing. Oh, wait, it's down at the bottom. Okay. Proto Man's helmet. Oh, that's cool. X's helmet. Cat hat. Link cap. Okay, that's pretty cool. Dunban wig. Majora's mask. And monkey hat. Alright, well, I'm gonna go back to having hibiscus because... I don't know. Let's see. Super Smash Bros. T-shirt. And the cat suit. Alright, that's something. Let's go ahead and go... I'll just use Brandon because he's a gunner. Let's take a look at his headgear. Oh no, the headgear is all going to be the same. Yeah, okay, that's all the same. It's the outfits that change with the class. Okay, so Smash Bros. T-shirts. That's the same. Proto Man's armor. That is really cool. And X's armor. Very, very cool. And the last one is the sword fighter. My guy's a Roman. Let's go ahead and Super Smash for the t-shirt, of course. Link outfit. So you can basically just dress them up like those characters. Dunban outfit. And monkey suit, where he just has a stick instead of a sword. Okay. So, I'm gonna Google afterwards, after this video is over, if Mewtwo does have any custom moves. If not, that's a little disappointing. But I... can't exactly complain, can I? Because Mewtwo is freaking here. And just to prove which challenges I still need to do, by the way. Or maybe they did that so that I don't have to collect them for this challenge or something. I don't know. I just need to collect all the custom moves and collect all the custom headgear. I only have one piece of headgear left to get, and it's the floral hat, and it's evading my every move, so who knows when I'm gonna get that. Also, I just bumped the mic, I'm sorry. So I think after almost 50 minutes that is gonna do it for this video. Also, one of the things, some characters have been buffed and nerfed, etc. I believe Diddy got a few nerfs. As far as I know, Robin got buffed and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff that happened, really. So, in the new update, in fact, if it's in here, no, it isn't. But either way, that is it. That is the 1.0.6 update, and that is my boy Mewtwo. So, yeah, that is going to do it for this episode. Also, this looks really awkward. I can't wait for Lucas just to fill out the character roster. Mewtwo. Anyways, that is going to do it. So thank you all for watching. Let me know if you guys got Mewtwo or the Mii stuff. Blah, 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 blah. If Mewtwo's going to be your new main. Also, one other thing that's annoying me. Link's up here and Kirby's up here. They're no longer by their respective series. That's going to bug me. You should have just put Mewtwo, like, I don't know, in here or something. I don't know. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next video, and I will see you guys then.